GST on Advance Receipt. This presentation will give you an overview on GST on Advance Receipt in Busy. If you have taken any advance amount from your parties and there is no billing or refund against that advance amount in that particular month, then on the pending advance amount, you need to deposit tax to the government. Basically, when you take advance, there can be two cases. Either you will do billing against that advance or you can refund that amount. But in a particular month, if there is some pending amount kept with you, then you need to deposit tax on that particular amount. However, in the next month, you can adjust the tax amount. That is, you can post a reversal entry for the tax already paid against advance. First of all, we'll enter a receipt voucher by going to transaction, receipt, add option. Here we are entering the receipt voucher on 2nd of July. That is, we have taken some advance amount from a party on 2nd of July. We'll take the GST nature as advance receipt. Now we'll credit the Arshia Enterprises party with 38,400 rupees and debit the cash with 38,400 rupees. On saving the voucher, an allocation of advance with GST window will appear. In the window, you need to create a reference for the advance amount you are taking. By default, the voucher number is appearing as reference number. If you want, you can modify it also. Advance amount 38,400 rupees and tax rate we have specified as 28%. That is, this 38,400 amount includes 28% GST. So the taxable amount is 30,000, 4200 CGST and 4200 SGST, as this is a local party. So we'll charge both CGST and SGST. Next, we'll enter one more receipt voucher on 3rd of July. GST nature advance receipt. We are crediting Kasturba Home Appliances party with 76,800 rupees and debiting cash with 76,800 rupees. On saving the voucher, allocation of advance with GST window will appear. We'll create a reference for this party. This 76,800 rupees also include 28% tax rate. Now we will enter a sale voucher. Here we are assuming that advance amount we have received from Arshia Enterprises on 2nd of July. For that, we are entering a sales voucher on 5th of July. We have taken sale type as LGST 28%, party Arshia Enterprises, and we are selling Eureka Force vacuum cleaner 6 pieces at the rate of 5,000 per piece. CGST 14%, 4200 rupees, and SGST 14%, 4200 rupees. On saving the voucher, an adjustment of advance with GST window will appear, in which we'll select the reference number that we have created in the receipt voucher for Arshia Enterprises. That is, the advance amount we have taken from the Arshia Enterprises will be adjusted against this sale transaction. Here, tax rate is 28%, so total advance amount is adjusted in this sale voucher. Next, we'll enter a payment voucher, assuming that the 76,800 rupees amount we have taken from Kasturba Home Appliances, we are refunding that amount. So we are entering this payment voucher on 5th of July and we are taking GST nature as refund against advance receipt. We are debiting the Kasturba Home Appliances party with 76,800 rupees and crediting the cash account with 76,800. On saving the voucher, an adjustment of advance with GST window will appear. In this window, we'll select the reference we have created for Kasturba Home Appliances when we have taken the advance amount. So this is cross-adjusted. The advance amount we have taken from Kasturba Home Appliances is now refunded to them. Now we will enter one more receipt voucher. We are entering this receipt voucher on 25th of July, and as per this voucher, we have taken 12,800 rupees as advance amount from Arshia Enterprises, and this amount also include 28% GST. That is, taxable amount 10,000 rupees and 2,800 GST amount. Next, we are entering one more receipt voucher on 26th of July. This voucher we are entering for Goodwill Enterprises. We have taken 35,400 rupees as advance amount from Goodwill Enterprises. This transaction includes 18% GST. So 30,000 is your taxable amount and 2,700 CGST and 2,700 SGST. So total 5,400 is your tax amount. Now we will enter a sales voucher on 2nd of August against the advance amount received on 25th of July. That is, the advance amount is received in the previous month and the billing has been done in next month. So we are entering this voucher on 2nd of August. Party Arshia Enterprises, we are selling Philips hair dryer 10 pieces at rupees 1000 per piece. 14% CGST and 14% SGST we have charged. On saving the voucher, an adjustment of advance with GST window will appear. In this window, we'll select the reference that we have created for the advance amount received on 25th of July. Next, we are entering a payment voucher, that is, we are refunding the amount received from Goodwill Enterprises on 26th of July. This amount has been refunded on 3rd of August. So again, the advance amount is received in the month of July, but the refund has taken place in the month of August. Now we'll go to transaction GST miscellaneous utilities menu and select the check post tax on advance receipt option. With this option, you can check the tax to be paid on pending advance amount, that is, in the month of July, if there is some pending advance amount for which no billing or no refund has taken place, then we need to deposit tax on that amount. So here we have generated this report for the month of July. On the screen you can see Busy is showing that there are two transactions against which you need to deposit the tax, that is, 4100 is your total tax amount. Advance amount we have received on 25th and 26th of July. For that we need to deposit tax to the government. Here only you can press the F4 key and post a journal voucher for the same. On pressing the F4 key, Busy is showing a generate tax on advance receipt voucher window, which is showing CGST, SGST output and CGST, SGST adjustable against advance accounts. Click save button to post the journal voucher, and in the journal voucher you can see CGST and SGST accounts have been credited with 4100 rupees and CGST and SGST adjustable against advance have been debited with 4100 rupees. Next, we'll select check post tax adjustable against advance option. With this option, you can view the tax to be adjusted in the current month, that is, the tax to be adjusted against advance in the current month, that the transaction which have taken place in this month, but for them advance has been taken in the preceding month. We are viewing this report for the month of August. Here you can see there are two transactions. One is a sale voucher on 2nd of August and one is refund on 3rd of August. For both this transaction, we have already paid the tax in the month of July. Now we'll post a reversal entry. We'll press the F4 key to post a journal voucher. Here on the screen you can see that CGST and SGST output accounts are debited by 4100 rupees and CGST adjustable against advance and SGST adjustable against advance accounts are credited with 4100 rupees. This is just the opposite of the entry we have posted in the month of July. Next, we'll go to display GSTR1 report. Here we are viewing this report for the month of July for the section 11.1A1 summary of advance received interest rate local transaction. On the screen, Busy has shown these two transactions. Next, we are viewing this report for the month of August for the section 11.1B1 summary of advance adjusted interest rate. That is, in the month of August, the amount of tax that has been adjusted, it will show that entry. Now you will be wondering that why it is showing the entry as 1400 rupees. Actually, it should be of 4100 rupees. Now, I'd like to tell you one thing, that this report will show only the billing transactions. For refund transactions, you need to go to the section 9B, debit note, credit note, refundable vouchers. This report will show that tax amount of 2700 rupees. Hope after going through this presentation you would be able to easily enter transactions related to advance receipt and check the tax that is to be deposited against the pending advance amount or any tax amount adjustable against advance. Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel.